Hello, this is Alex Edelman.
And this is Gary Leland, and you're listening to episode 93 of the Crypto Cousins Podcast.
Feed your interest in Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies by joining Hall of Fame podcaster Gary Leland on the Crypto Cousins Podcast. And remember, we are all cousins in the world of crypto. This week's price of Bitcoin.
$5,841. That's up $613, or 11.6% over the last 7 days. Howdy, howdy, howdy. Alex, welcome to the show from New York there.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, so you were telling me in the pre-show you live pretty close to Marty. He was on a couple of episodes ago, Marty Ben.
Yeah, we had dinner the other night. He's a great guy, and love everything that he's done for the space, from like stacking sats to, you know, all his influence, even like getting newbies on board and crypto education, just kind of everything.
He's co-host Matt has been helping me try to set up my Lightning node, which I've been having problems with. I'm about giving up on it and sending it back and getting another brand. But he's been trying to help me get mine set up. I think he's kind of given up on it too. But yeah, Marty's a good guy. I like Marty.
Yeah, we've become friends, I guess, over the last few months of just being, I guess, nearby. And also, I think, having a similar thesis for the future of Bitcoin.
Well, give us a short, minute or two brief bio so people know a little bit about you before we get started.
Yeah, so born and raised in North Carolina, and just basically started building technology early, pretty young age. Became pretty fascinated with just the internet in general, and then started building things with like a lot of different people. Started a company after college called Cosmic, and we built this e-commerce gateway that had this mission of democratizing commerce, giving people anywhere in the world the ability to buy and sell anywhere. And about halfway through that, we learned about Bitcoin. My team and I learned about Bitcoin. And we just sort of got pretty obsessed with it on a personal level about everything that Bitcoin was able to do to democratize commerce. We ended up getting acquired by our biggest customer, PopSugar, to come in and power $1.2 billion in retail revenue at ShopStyle. And then about a year later, after a lot of growth, we ended up getting acquired by Ebates, the biggest cashback company in the U.S. So two very different acquisitions, built it over about 7 years. And after we parted ways with Ebates, we started to look at like what we wanted to do. And we kept coming back to Bitcoin and the distribution issue. So we took what we knew from our worlds in media and in commerce, and most recently at the time in the cashback space. And we kept thinking that the cashback model would be a really interesting way to make Bitcoin accessible to everybody. Not just letting people mine it, not just letting the small percentage of people invest in it, but opening it up to the hundreds of millions, if not billions of people all around the world that shop and increasingly shop online. So we built an early version. We launched about 7 months ago, and we've had a lot of success so far with getting merchant adoption, educating merchants on Bitcoin, having a really easy way for them to get into Bitcoin. We have over 750 merchants to this day. And then on the user side, getting people that are first timers acclimated and teaching them about the importance of Bitcoin and setting them up with their first wallets and all that fun stuff.
Well, I do want to let everybody know this is not a paid episode. I found this real interesting, and I contacted Alex to come on the show. So I want to make sure people know that this isn't a commercial. We're just something I'm interested in. So Lolly is the site. You know, and every morning when I log into my online version of QuickBooks, guess what I see up in the right-hand corner? Lolly.
Yeah.
Every morning I see that. So every morning I think of you and I see that every day because I have to log in every morning and put in the sales from yesterday for my businesses.
That's amazing. Yes. I love that. As a few of our users have described it as this like little elf that pops up. I feel like there's something there. So it's, I know I'm biased, but like every time I see it, it's like this joy that it just sort of like comes up and it reminds me that Bitcoin exists, that I can earn it. And reminds me to check my balance and all that stuff. So I think a lot of what we think about with like the product is like creating this like positive feedback loop around Bitcoin, making it an exciting experience, making like drawing attention to Bitcoin and creating rituals around Bitcoin.
Well, if you watch any TV at all, I think you have to know what Ebates is. I mean, my gosh, they have had a major advertising. And so basically Lolly is like Ebates, but for crypto. Would that be an easy way to describe it?
Yeah, that we've kept it very simple. That's exactly what it is.
I've set up my account. I don't know that I've gone anywhere and used it yet or not, but I have one set up. Like I said, I already had QuickBooks, so I don't use it there. But what are some of the top merchants? I mean, you said you had 750 merchants. How about, and we know QuickBooks is one of them because I just said that. Tell us a few more merchants that are on the system.
So our top category is going to be travel. I think a lot of people are using it for flights, for hotels, car rentals even. So Priceline, Booking.com are two of our biggest there. Hilton, Marriott are doing really well. And then we have a lot of essentials. So groceries at Jet. We have Walmart.com is one of our biggest. Overstock has been an amazing partner. Best Buy has been great. Yeah, we have a lot of different partners like Macy's.
Are they all going to come up like QuickBooks does for me?
Most of them will. So about 98% of our partners come up automatically. And our retailers love it. It increases their conversion. They're happy to have a new customer. They're happy to have a customer that keeps coming back because they know they're going to be earning Bitcoin. Some of our customers don't like that because they feel that person would have already shopped there. And so for some customers, you have to give
them. They're going, now I'm paying them and they would have come here anyway.
Exactly. Part of the business model is like driving people to lolly.com. It's very simple. You go to lolly.com, you press shop, and you can see our whole list of merchants. We're actually rolling out a lot of changes on the shop side of the house where people can search per product, search per retailer. So we're adding a lot of functionality there. We also have sort of a thing, like a fun little feature right now where you can message our support team and we're on call most of the day. And you can just say, hey, I'm looking for new pants or an air fryer or whatever it is. It was a recent request. And we'll go find it for you and we'll find the most Bitcoin back. So we're really trying to have a better customer experience than even I think in the fiat world and really associate Bitcoin with like high customer, like a great customer experience and high retention and high engagement.
So the best way to use Lolly then is to go to the site, not to get on the internet and hope that thing pops up.
Correct. Yeah. So it really depends on how active you want to be with it. I think once people have their first moment where they were like, oh my God, this thing is real. I'm earning Bitcoin. I'm earning like a lot. They're like, okay, how do I earn more? But the best way to start is just like to go to the site and look at all the sites that you have things that you might need over the next couple months. We've had a lot of people shift from Amazon. So Amazon's been our biggest holdout. We've been talking to them for months and they really just want to see how active our users are. They want to see how many users we have. And so far we've been able to prove to them that we are sending a lot of traffic away from Amazon to Jet, to Walmart, to Overstock. And the more that we do that, the more our platform is going to be of interest to them to bring them on Lolly. We haven't, I don't think, sent enough sales away from them, but we've sent quite a bit of traffic and revenue away from Amazon. So we just keep sending them anonymized data saying, we have sent $1 million away from your site to similar partners. And every month that we send that to them, it piques their interest more. So really, I mean, if you shop at Amazon and you're not getting any Bitcoin back, you might as well start looking at other places that are going to be pro-Bitcoin companies. And we have over 750 merchants. You can find just about everything that you would find at Amazon at one of our merchants. The most popular has been Jet to really replace a lot of the essentials that you would normally buy at Amazon.
And then what percent, or is it a set fee that the people get in Bitcoin? Like if I buy something for $100, is it like I always get 3% in Bitcoin or 5% or 1%, or does that vary from site to site?
It really varies. We're constantly negotiating rates with these merchants. So it goes up to, I think our highest right now is 45% on eHarmony. And our lowest is probably around like 1%. And the nice part is, I think a lot of people think that it conflicts with your credit card points or your cash back points. It actually is complementary. So it's like you can stack on top of all of your points already getting.
Get your points on your credit cards, and then you're getting Bitcoin to boot.
Exactly. So these are all separate negotiations. We have separate deals with all of these merchants, and we have direct partnerships with a lot of our top merchants. So I think our average commission rate is 7%. So with a lot of these, you're getting about 7% on top of credit card points, on top of cashback, and it goes into your Bitcoin wallet. You earn, you stack as you're shopping. It's pretty simple. We try to keep it really simple.
Yeah, there's not really a learning curve here. It's pretty simple. Matter of fact, if you were using Lolly just 3 months ago, that 7% is now 14% since crypto's almost doubled, right? So, I mean, you know, it's a pretty good deal. I do want to say, now I have an affiliate code with y'all, which is CryptoCousins.com/Lolly. Now, if I'm correct, what does that do? That gets me $5 and a person signing up $5 or something? What's the scoop on that affiliate code? I don't even know what it is.
$5. Yeah, you get $5 in Bitcoin, and whoever signs up gets $5 in Bitcoin. So, yeah, any listeners can go use
that.
That's
a lose deal there.
Yeah, it's win-win. I mean, we want people to use it. Like, I think that, like, if you have $5 in your Lolly wallet, you're going to want to use it, and you're going to want to, like, so the more people that use it, the people are going to shift their shopping habits over to our merchants. And the more merchants that see that Bitcoin users are a active market, the more that they'll adopt Bitcoin. So because we have all these merchant partnerships, we want to be at the forefront of getting merchant adoption. I think we have deeper partnerships than anybody in the merchant space. So as we start to engage these merchants, and we have a super easy like onboarding process for them, we get them set up really easily. Over time, let's just say like 3 or 4 years down the road, I can go to Walmart and say, hey, I've driven $50 million in sales to your site. Now I think it would be a good time to start thinking about accepting Bitcoin. And for all these users that have been using Bitcoin over the years and want to start using Bitcoin as a payments platform, both domestically and internationally, this is a really good chance for them to start to vote with their dollars and start to use Bitcoin as not just a store of value as they're using it now, but also as a currency and a medium of exchange.
Well, do y'all have a goal to be in play then too with helping stores with that part of it as well?
Correct. Okay. So so our last company, Cosmic, was a payments gateway and a e-commerce gateway more so. And so that's actually probably closer in line with the technology we were building with our last company. It was, you know, PCI level one compliant. It was a really cool technology. So we'll probably go back to our roots there and build some really cool payment functionality around making it really easy for people to pay all their favorite merchants and earn. Because you sort of add another incentive with merchants. They don't have to pay the credit card companies. They don't have to pay the banks. They could just use Bitcoin processing and do, you know, transact with Lightning Network and super low fees. They could do cross-border. There's a lot of merchants that are already starting to have their interest piqued by Bitcoin, but there's a lot in the background that has to be solved. I think Bakkt's doing some really cool things, and then, you know, BitPay has been out there for years. So there's a lot of networks out there that are solving a lot of these issues on the infrastructure layer, and hopefully we'll sort of be this bridge between the consumer and the merchant on top of the infrastructure networks that are being built right now.
Okay, sounds great. Hey, before going further, I just want to make sure everybody out there knows about my conference coming up in August in Dallas, Texas, is BitBlock Boom. I don't know if you've heard of this or not, Alex. Your friend Marty is going to be there, and Matt, both are speaking, doing a live episode of their podcast at BitBlock Boom. But that's scheduled. Our second BitBlock Boom conference is scheduled for August the 17th and 18th. We have a ton of great speakers. I'm not going to go through them all, but if you use the code COUSINS, COUSINS, at checkout, you'll receive 30% off the price of your ticket. So go to bitblockboom.com, check out the lineup. We're about halfway sold out on tickets. We're only selling 125 tickets. So check it out and sign up for bitblockboom.com today. I hope I see you in Dallas, everybody. But yeah, you should come. You'll have a good time, Alex. You should come.
Yeah, that sounds great. I
think
you've got
a lot of people there.
Yeah, good barbecue.
Marty said it was his favorite conference of the year last year.
Wow, nice.
That was a lot. I felt like that was a recommendation. Hey, what do you expect to happen to Lolly? And I want to make sure everybody knows that's Lolli.
Yes.
What do you expect to happen to Lolly when the bull market, if we hit that bull market again? I mean, which the last month's been looking kind of good, but what happens if we start hitting 20,000 or 30,000? I mean, you guys have already projected this. I'm sure you're not just sitting there going, whoa, we'll figure that out when we get there. So what do you see happening to Lolly in that situation?
So price historically has basically been this attention engine. I personally don't think too much about the price. Personally, I think I've been in space for a while. I care about more of the principles of Bitcoin than I do the price. I think that price, if we're sort of clearing everything we know about Bitcoin and treating it from the perspective of a first-time user, price drives attention. Every time the price goes up, the media covers it. Every time price crashes, the media covers it. So the more attention we have, I think the more users we'll get and more people that will come into the space. I think we've already probably reached the Coinbase and Kraken and all the exchanges have probably reached a lot of the investors that were ever or going to invest in Bitcoin. And sure, there's going to be a whole nother wave of investors, younger investors, people that are like more excited about it. But I think the investor market is very small. It's not going to make Bitcoin a medium of exchange. It's not going to make Bitcoin a true store of value. I think what has to happen is you need retail consumers to come in, and you need Bitcoin across tens of millions, hundreds of millions of people that are using it, that are investing in it, that know about it. And in order for that to happen, you have to reach a much larger market. So the two markets I think I'm most excited about are shopping and earning through work. So, you know, we're going after the earning through shopping. It's what we know best. We know all these merchants. And I think we can really help the Bitcoin space through shopping. So that's what we're excited about. If it goes up to 20, great. If it slowly, you know, goes up to 10, I'm really happy. I actually don't care for the giant ups and downs. I actually had a tweet the other day where I like when it's just slowly, quote unquote, slowly going up. When we launched like 3,500 to 5,500 over the last 6 months, because every time our users come in, it's sort of like dollar cost averaging this earning. And I think that builds a better behavior and a better perspective of, well, you said it earlier, like Bitcoin for a Lolli user has almost doubled. So it's twice as good as cashback programs. And if you're positioning it across cashback programs, we are better than like the Ebates of the world. We're better than the, you know, the other cashback programs out there. So if we continue to do that, then we're going to be positioned way better and people are going to use us instead of our cashback competitors.
Well, I agree with you completely. The slow rise is much better than, for example, 2017. I think between November and Christmas, we went up double or triple. I mean, you know, in a short amount of time there, and you saw what happened after that happened. So y'all don't have an app for this, do you? It's just a website.
It's just a website, yeah. So people spend still most of their dollars shopping online so they can get the most back. And there's just like higher rates there. We are actively working towards building a mobile application that lets people shop from their phone and also shops in store, driving people into the stores and doing everything, everyday purchases. Kind of going back to what we were talking about earlier about rituals. I would love for people every day when they go get their coffee at their favorite coffee shop to be able to earn Bitcoin. When they go to their grocery store to be able to earn Bitcoin. So taking everyday experiences and earning Bitcoin. And in order to make that jump away from web and into mobile, I think that that's the sort of experience that we have to have. So that's the direction of Lolli over the next year or so, giving you more ways to earn. But I think right now, as you noted, it's a really easy way to earn and you can shop at over 750 merchants like to this day. So
I have the largest wallpaper store in Texas, and I've had my website for my wallpaper store went online in like 96.
Wow.
Yeah, I've been doing this a long time. That's just one of my websites, one of my sites. And I just thought of this now because you were talking about these. What would it take for a store like mine to get on Lolli? What's the scoop on that?
Just reach out to us. Well, we try to figure it out. And it's really minimal integration for some of our bigger partners like Walmart. And we do direct partnerships there. But probably like our top few hundred merchants, we do direct partnerships where it makes financial sense to. If you're on like an affiliate network, we can hook up to the affiliate network if that works best for you. Really, we just try to make it really easy. For most merchants, we can get them up and running in less than 24 hours. Oh. But yeah, I encourage you to just reach out to us. We have a support channel for customers, we have a support channel for potential partners. Just reach out, send us your website, and we'll figure out a way to get you on board.
I'll send that in. Maybe I should. We accept Bitcoin on the website. We have that, and we have a sporting goods store website, too. And a
store. Oh, nice. What are they called?
Well, the wallpaper store is Leland's Wallpaper, and my sporting goods store has got, I've got several websites for the store, but it's softballjunk.com, baseballjunk.com, sportsjunk.com, I think is the master site. But softballjunk.com is the one that we really do a ton of business on. But Baseball Junk does good, too. In 2000, I had the first website for women's fast pitch softball. They all use baseball websites or men's slow pitch websites. So automatically, it took off. Like, you know, within 6 months, we were doing $2 million a year, just me messing around in my garage. just because no one else had done it.
Wow.
Yeah. And my daughter played. So that's why we did it. So I need to definitely get together since I take Bitcoin on them. I need to definitely get together because I'd probably be the only sporting goods store and wallpaper store in your system there. So I kind of have an exclusive on it.
Yeah. Yeah. We'll send people your way. We give people all the time to make requests for just about everything. So I'm sure at some point someone's asked for wallpaper and we haven't been able to help them. So yeah.
Well, you answered a lot of my questions indirectly because I know you believe in Bitcoin now just from your conversation. It's not just something that you're doing for the job. From the way you're talking, you believe in Bitcoin as a currency in the future.
Correct. Yeah, I think that Bitcoin or something that looks a lot like it, I think will connect everyone in the world through commerce. And I think that that is a better world that we'll live in. If we can transact freely with people from all countries, everywhere, if we're connected by a common currency, I think that that's a better world. And so Bitcoin looks like that. And it just, I think, has made my life better in a lot of ways. And I believe in the principles behind it. So yeah, I'm really excited for the future of it. We're really focused on Bitcoin and have high hopes for the Bitcoin network. And then, yeah, I mean, I'm open, always open. Like I'm not a 100% maximalist. Like I'm open to new projects. But I mean, I've been in this space for a little while now, and I just haven't seen hundreds, if not thousands, of different projects, and nothing has proven to me to be competitive in a real way with Bitcoin. So all ears, but Bitcoin is what has really inspired me, and I think is what people really want and really all they need for the time being to get involved in the space.
I agree with you 100%. Now, I have a question on the wallets on Lolli. You said when you get set up your Lolli account, you have a wallet. And if I bought something at Walmart online, I get some crypto in some Bitcoin in my wallet. So that's just like any regular wallet. I can transfer that over to my regular wallet. There's nothing hard about it. It's pretty simple, cut and dried.
Yep. You just go to lolli.com/account and you just see all your available funds and you can transfer to a Bitcoin address. Or if you want to transfer out to fiat, you're welcome to do that as well. We can hook into your bank account and I think one thing that like people should know is that we have a pending amount at which point the retailer, as a merchant, that if you have a 60-day return period, if someone returns on the 70th day, but you've already paid out in Bitcoin, then that would break your model and it's ripe for fraud. So we do have a pending, whatever the retailer's return policy is, whether 30 or 60, 90 days, we have to abide by that. So what you'll see is this pending amount. And whenever the merchant locks that in and pays us, that's when we send the Bitcoin to your Lolli wallet. And then you can do whatever you want. So, not your keys, not your coin. And we can send it to whatever Bitcoin wallet that you want.
So you think Lolli will ever offer, Ethereum or anything else? Or do you just plan on always being Bitcoin?
I'll never say never, but I think Ethereum would have to prove a lot to me.
I just was using that as an example. I don't mean that coin in particular. I just meant another coin or is it pretty much just you want to keep it simple and do Bitcoin?
Okay. I believe in free markets. I believe that people, everybody should be able to earn what they want. And so eventually, I could see potentially just opening it up. I think we've had maybe probably less than 5 requests from different communities that have been active users. And a lot of people are just using it. They'll earn Bitcoin and they can do whatever they want with it. So they can go transfer it out and go buy Ethereum. We're not stopping anyone from doing anything. It is a free market. Bitcoin is the segue and it lets them go buy whatever they want if they really want to. But I personally think for the sake of we're just reaching a very new customer. An investor might want to come in and they want all these options. They want to be able to day trade. But someone who's new to it just wants to see what it's like and learn about it. I don't know. I guess we're sort of still trying to figure out what our consumers want. And we really haven't had a lot of demand from other communities that have been as active as Bitcoin. So we're going to serve our customer and we're going to provide the best customer experience. But right now we're Bitcoin only.
Well, you're really helping with Bitcoin adoption then too, as far as spreading the word and get people into Bitcoin and get their first bit of Bitcoin, which is a really good thing. Well, I was curious, where do you get your Bitcoin to give away? You just don't go to Coinbase and buy that. Do you buy that over the counter or
Yeah, we have a few OTCs that we know, vetted, and trust. And so we're buying on the best rates in the market.
Right.
Because we're such an active buyer, we're able to look across probably 15 plus exchanges across all these OTCs. And so we're getting really good rates, very like good like competitive rates for our users, and then we pass those off to our users. So yeah, we're going in and buying the Bitcoin. Eventually, you can see us potentially mining our own and having a direct source, but there's really no point of doing that at this point in the business. Right. And so yeah, that's where we're at right now.
Well, I was going to say, I'm sure you're not just like going to coin or something buying it. So I was just curious that how much
we get killed by fees.
yeah, for sure. Approximately how much Bitcoin? I know you can't tell me secrets, so if I'm asking something, it's a secret. But just say I can't answer that. But how much Bitcoin do you think y'all give out in a month or a year?
So we haven't started disclosing that yet. I'm happy with our growth. I'm happy with like how we're doing. We did just pass 14,000 users. So that's like active shoppers that are using our platform.
That was my next question.
Yeah. So we are sharing that as, and we're growing with the community. We want all of our users to grow and share, and that's been really cool. We'll start sharing more numbers as we grow. I mean, I think one question just like proactively that a lot of people have is about privacy. And just given like our team's background and especially, you know, our technical team is extremely focused on ensuring privacy, ensuring security. So I think that we just want to like have all of our users rest assured that like we are looking out for everyone's privacy. We're not selling data. It's a very simple relationship with the merchant. We're saying you shop this site, you get your Bitcoin. We don't know what you bought. We just know you spent $50 at Walmart and then we go give you your Bitcoin. Like we try to keep it really simple. We're not getting fancy with it. We want to respect people's privacy. We need to know enough data that we can give you your Bitcoin, and that's about it.
Well, if someone received, I'm going to just say hypothetically, during the year they're shopping and they receive $1,000 worth of BTC as their rewards, do they get like a income tax statement from you guys saying, hey, you got $1,000 worth of BTC? Or
so rebates are not taxable income. And everybody should
know that. I didn't know that. Thanks.
Yeah, no, it's not well known. It's sort of like deep tax law. And so I'm not an accountant, so I can't advise anyone on... Right. I'm not a CPA, but everybody should talk to their accountants officially. But if you look up like rebates law, I think most accountants, but all of our accountants, have, that's been their stance, is that all rebates are not taxable income. So it's not treated the same way as you going and buying Bitcoin. So as long as you're holding your Bitcoin and it's just, you know, going up in value, you shouldn't have any issues with like actually receiving it. But talk to your accountants and yeah.
And I'm not a financial advisor either.
Yeah. What is it? Verify, don't trust?
Yeah. I had a guest last week that said, nowadays, if you're trust, you're just lazy because you don't have to trust. In the old days, you had to trust. You didn't have the internet. Now, you're just lazy if you trust now. It's all there for you to research.
Yeah. Verify, don't trust. So do your homework.
Let me ask you a couple questions real quick. What's your favorite book?
Favorite book?
Or book you're reading or?
Yeah. I love reading a lot of different things. What I'm reading right now, I'm reading a lot of like Alan Watts. I'm really into like philosophy right now and really like a lot of his like lectures and just the questions he poses. Reading The Beginning of Infinity. I'm really enjoying that. Also, you know, some philosophy. Reading some fantasy right now with Neil Gaiman's Stardust. Just finished Shoe Dog. That was inspiring on just like an entrepreneur. Everything that Phil Knight did and all the ups and downs of building Nike. I think we're fascinating. Love The Bitcoin Standard. I think I send it to like all of our, it's such a good book. And it really teaches you about
be in our event. So,
yeah. Oh, nice. That's awesome. So yeah, we send it to like new employees, new partners. We've converted a lot of our merchants to like Bitcoin.
You send them the copy. You send them Safe's book.
Oh yeah. All the time.
Yeah.
Yeah. I should get a wholesale discount or something. I like just stacking stats when I send it, but because you can get it from Barnes and Nobles and earn Bitcoin and read it. So I just keep buying it and sending it.
That book is so eye-opening on what money is. I mean, until you read that, you really don't know what money is even.
Exactly. When I meet with merchants, the curious smart ones will always ask me like, why Bitcoin? Why does it matter? And then they'll come back to me like a few weeks later after we've already signed and they'll be like, can you send me something? Like, I just want to like learn more. And like, I always send them that book and the ones that are like really curious. And then our conversations, you know, I think this happens just with everybody that is interested in Bitcoin, but they'll come back and they'll be like, hey, I like learned this. I saw this. And I think my biggest learning of being in the space for a little while has just been that most people don't understand money in general. And so they have to understand money to understand Bitcoin. But in order to understand all of that, they have to have some sort of skin in the game. And most people are not willing to invest in something if they don't understand it, whereas someone's willing to earn it for free if they don't understand it. So that's why I think like Wally comes in. It's super easy to get involved. You earn a little bit, and then you start paying attention, and then you start earning, and then you start learning more about it.
Well, I think that's why whenever I would have friends that were interested in Bitcoin, I try not to like instruct anyone on advice of any kind, because if something goes wrong, I don't want them on me. But I always recommend something. I say, hey, just buy $100 worth if you're thinking about it. Don't say, I'm going to buy $5,000 worth when it hits this. Just buy $100 and watch it. Watch it go up and watch it go down and follow it and get some skin in the game. And then you go, oh my gosh, it went down 25%. Oh, it went up 30%, you know, and kind of get used to that before you have thousands in there and you're having a heart attack.
Exactly. Yeah, that's our advice as well. I don't think I've ever given financial advice, even to family, friends, or whatever. And I think my family is probably mad that I didn't tell them to buy Bitcoin, but I'm always very adamant that you should do your research, you should do your homework, you should understand anything before you buy it.
I think you got a lot of less chance of losing some friends if you don't give them that advice. You know, give them that advice to buy some when it was January of 2018, when it was 19,000, they might not be your friend today.
Exactly.
So what is your favorite crypto resource?
Arjun Balaji, a person, he's sort of my, I would say like anytime I have a tough technical problem or question, or I'm trying to like wrap my head around something, I'll normally go to him. He's been awesome. Marty's been great. Pierre's
close to you too, isn't he?
Yeah. So we've never actually met in person. Might meet him actually later.
You should come down here to BitBlock Boom. He's going to be here. Everybody's here, guy, except for you.
Yeah.
All your neighbors.
I got to get down there. So Pierre's been awesome on the Lightning Network side. Elizabeth Stark's been awesome on the Lightning side. Everyone's just been so welcoming. I feel like, you know, I've been in the space, but not really like deep in the space. Just sort of been sort of a lurker in the Bitcoin community for the last like several years. And just over the last year since we've gotten out there and launched, I think everyone's just been super welcoming, and I like love this community, and everyone I think really likes what we're doing. We're just making what they've been talking about for so many years accessible to everybody. So I think we see the world in a lot of the same ways, and there's been a lot of like great resources out there. What are your favorite resources?
My favorite resource is Safe's book, to be honest with you. I couldn't put that book down. I mean, I think that's my favorite resource. I read a lot of blogs. I'd have to say Feedly Blog Reader is my next favorite resource, because I can subscribe to all those blogs and go to one place and read the content. So it's not a crypto thing, but I use it for learning about crypto and keeping up to date on new cryptos using Feedly and Twitter.
Twitter. I was just going to say, I think that you brought up a good point with it being like a platform. Just getting involved in the Twitter community has been amazing. Like, people are super helpful, and they really get like the viral loop going and sharing the message that we want to get out there. So that's been an awesome platform for us
I think I opened my Twitter account in 2006, so like really early, and I really never used it ever. I got my name and I just sat on it. And in 2017, when I got into crypto, so I haven't been in it that long, I started using Twitter for that. And now I live in Twitter. So I'm glad I got my name back when I did, but I really didn't find a use for it until I got into crypto. And it's, my gosh, crypto Twitter is just huge. And there's so many people. That's how I contacted you, you know.
Yeah.
And my next guest for next week, I contacted on Twitter. I found that to be the best tool ever out of everything now that I'm used to using it. So yeah, Twitter is fantastic.
I totally agree. Made a lot of good friends. Modern friends is what one of my friends says. Modern friends on it.
So where's the best place for people to keep up with you or follow you?
Try Lolly. It's at Try Lolly on Twitter. We're super active on there. Always tweeting out like the best Bitcoin back deals, our new partner announcements. We're at about like one new partner a week, new major partner. We're adding partners a lot, but new major partner every week. We're announcing a really big partner next week that I'm really excited about. We're doing an integration with them.
Announce it now.
If people rush to the site, it would be a bad experience. So,
okay.
Follow us on Twitter and
I was just messing with you. I didn't.
I want to. I wish I could.
But this doesn't go live for 3 more days. So
I'll come on next week and we'll do it. We'll do a quick show and an announcement. And we'll talk about what it's going to do. So it's going to be a big one. It's probably our biggest one in a couple months. So well, I'm pretty excited for it.
Yeah, everybody needs to go check, follow you, and so they can keep up with this.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Hey, thanks for coming on the show. And remember, everybody, I'm going to say it again. Use my affiliate account if you sign up for this. I could use some support. CryptoCousins.com/LOLLI, Lolly. And thanks, Alex, for coming on the show. Maybe I'll see you up in New York. I still haven't decided either way on that. So maybe I'll see you up there if I come up there and take Marty's invite for Consensus next week.
We'll get a nice whiskey. I know that's Marty's drink of choice.
Yeah, that's his drink of choice there. I'll drink about anything. I'm not I'm not choosing.
I don't discriminate.
Thanks for coming on. I hope you enjoyed today's show. A big thank you to all the cousins out there that are showing their support by donating, subscribing, and leaving great reviews on iTunes. All of those things help more than you realize. Now, you can subscribe almost anywhere podcasts are available by going to CryptoCousins.com/subscribe. Call me with your comments or questions at 747-777-9471. Or you can email me at thecryptocousins@gmail.com, and I'll try to use these on future episodes. Please take a peek at the 4-Minute Crypto Show, which is produced every weekday and located at 4MinuteCrypto.com. It's the place to get your daily dose of crypto news, and as always, 4 minutes or less. And one last thing, please take a look at my new website, Crypto Crybaby. This website is for the true crypto fan and sells Bitcoin and crypto gear like t-shirts, caps, and so much more. Take a look at CryptoCrybaby.com today. Thanks again for listening. Love you guys.
Thanks for listening to the Crypto Cousins podcast. Please share the show with your friends. They can subscribe by going to CryptoCousins.com/subscribe. And if you want to know more about Gary, just go to GaryLeland.com. Make sure and join Gary and all the Crypto Cousins every week for a new episode of the Crypto Cousins podcast. The Crypto Cousins podcast and the information included in the podcast are not intended as investment advice. Investing in any cryptocurrency is risky, and you should never invest more than you can afford to lose. Always seek professional advice before investing in any cryptocurrency. Please understand, you are using any and all information from the Crypto Cousins at your own risk.